ever.
Make the world go away and get it off my shoulders. Say the things you used to say.
Hey, Stephanie, my wife and I need to stay here another night.
And make the world.
Sure, but I need to have a word with you. I've been losing a lot of customers here.
And what does that have to do with me?
Think about it, Fillmore. Why would anyone want to stay in an already trashy motel that has a poor couple living here?
Stephanie, please. Have a heart.
Well, this is a motel, not a homeless shelter. If you and your wife don't find a place soon, I'll have to evict you.
Don't worry. Tonight is our last night here. I promise.
Okay, but one more night.
Thanks.
Now, where did I put those darn brochures?
I'm sorry if I've hurt you. I'll make it day by day. Just tell me that you love me. And make the world.
Fillmore, I don't mean to complain, but we have to get out of here. We've been living in this shabby motel for weeks.
Don't worry, baby, because tonight is our last night here.
No way! Are those...
Yes, ma'am. 2 first-class cruise tickets to Vice City. Our ship leaves tomorrow.
How did you get those?
Same way I got our car. I stole them.
I love you so much, Fillmore.
I love you too, sweetie pie. We can have a long, beautiful life ahead of us. I'll be right back. I need to get some champagne from the car so we can celebrate.
What's taking him so damn long? Hello?
Hello, Nadine.
Fillmore, is this you? What the hell are you doing?
Sorry, but this isn't Fillmore, but he did seem like a very nice husband who stole tickets for you.
Okay, stop it, Fillmore. Is this some kind of joke? You're creeping me out.
Does it sound like I'm joking to you? I'm afraid you won't be boarding the ship to Vice City tomorrow.
Stephanie! Stephanie, open the door! Please help me! He's gonna kill me!
Wow, it's huge.
I can't believe it either. I didn't know it'd be this fancy.
Fancy? Are you kidding me? It's incredible! A 1.5-day cruise to the most partying island in the Atlantic, Vice City. Let's get this party started!
Brent, please. That's very aggravating.
Oh, Bridget. Let your son have some fun. It's his 21st birthday. Don't you remember when you were young and wild?
He can have as much fun as he wants to, as long as he doesn't embarrass or annoy me.
Well, at least someone's happy. What's wrong, Felicity? You've been down all morning.
It's just that this romantic cruise line reminds me so much of Ben. I can't believe he left me without reason or a proper goodbye.
Well, if he ditched you like that, then he isn't even worth your time, let alone your emotions.
I know, but he just seemed like the romantic type. We really shared so many intimate moments and memories.
Well, we went on this vacation to create fun and relaxing memories. So lighten up. This cruise was supposed to help you feel better anyway.
I guess you're right. Maybe I'll find my true love aboard this ship.
Hey, don't hold your breath.
Oh my gosh! Joe Winko!
Who are you?
My name is Cole. I'm your biggest fan.
Oh my god, not again!
What the hell are you doing here? This is a private cruise line for paying customers only.
I googled Joe Winko and the cruise line information website told me that he purchased a ticket there. I couldn't resist meeting him!
I'm not sure if you're aware, but that's considered stalking, which is a serious crime that could result in prosecution under proper court of law.
Would you get lost? He doesn't want to be bugged by you. We're not in the mood.
Pardon me, but I couldn't help to overhear that he said your name was Joe Winko.
Yeah, that's me.
It's a pleasure to meet you. I'm Allison. I read your book, How to Survive. It was very detailed.
Thanks. So, what brings you here?
My parents are sending me away to a high school for the gifted. I received a free scholarship because my academic scores were always at maximum since kindergarten, and my IQ result was 155.
Oh wow, congratulations.
Yeah, very impressive.
This sucks! Mom, Dad, you guys should have just gotten me a ticket instead. I don't want to drag deadweight Pamela with me. What are you talking about, Heather? Both of us know that I deserve this vacation way more than you do.
Girl, stop arguing, please.
Your father is right. We bought these tickets for your 18th birthday because we wanted to give you both a chance to bond with each other.
How is being with my stupid twin sister for a whole week a good way to celebrate my 18th birthday? I love the cruise idea, but bringing Heather with me is just ruining it. You're just jealous because Mom and Dad like me more than you.
Cut it out! Now your mother and I are letting you two take this trip by yourselves, so behave! And don't forget to call us once you girls reach Vice City!
Whatever.
Hello, sexy ladies. Looking for a fun time?
In your dreams, pervert!
Is that what you girls are into? S&M? Hold up!
Is this socks awesome or what?
Looking cool, JJ.
As always. By the way, do you want to come downstairs to the machine room with me later? I heard that we can get some very cool concert echoes down there.
I have to get some more footage of that hot babe who walked aboard earlier.
You mean Ivy? Are you kidding me? Don't be a dweeb, Wayne. She's so stuck up and snobby. She'll only give you a chance if you have a $2 million bill on you.
She's sexy.
So is this guitar.
Dad, do I really have to stay here? We haven't even started sailing yet.
You must, Gabe. You're my assistant captain. You always wanted to help me sail and follow in my footsteps.
Yeah, back when I was 5.
Gabe, please don't make this difficult. Now, what do we need to do first?
When the water ahead looks clear of any obstacles, so let's launch the ship at 30 miles per hour.
Aren't you forgetting something?
I don't think so.
First, you need to sound the boat horn symbol, then send out a broadcast warning other ships that we're underway.
Whatever!
Excuse me, are you the captain of the ship?
Most certainly. Anything I can do for you, ma'am?
I just wanted to remind you that I expect 5-star quality treatment on the ship, since I deserve it, of course.
Oh, okay. We can guarantee that.
Then we shouldn't have a problem at all.
Excuse me. Are you Captain Willis?
Yes, sir. What can I do for you?
I'm Albert Wesker. I work with the Myrtle Beach Police Department. And here's my partner, Sherry Chambers. She's a rookie in training.
We just wanted to remind you that we'll be boarding the ship to look out for any suspicious activity.
Why?
A couple was found dead at a motel not far from here. A young woman named Stephanie survived the attack. She's a witness of the crime. She told us that the killer was wearing a Ghostface costume and was seen taking 2 cruise ship tickets from the victim's body.
Joe Winko and Briary Rose Harold are also aboard the ship. They were the main targets of many Ghostface killing sprees that happened.
Do we need to postpone this voyage at all?
That won't be necessary. Sherry and I will be aboard this boat to keep watch of everything.
Okay, thank goodness.
Is it me, or is this ship more deserted than usual?
Well, it is a private cruise line. Of course it's going to be deserted.
Yeah, especially with the Angels of Death aboard our ships.
Angels of Death? What are you talking about?
Joe Winko and Briary. Duh. The captain told us he had to give 50 refunds because everyone found out they were coming aboard.
Wow. Talk about paranoid. I feel so sorry for them.
I feel more sorry for the people who always die whenever they come aboard.
It's true. Everywhere they went, people died. It was never them.
That's just too freaky.
Hey! How are you guys?
Hi, Margaret. Taking another cruise again, aren't you?
Are you kidding me? I love this ship! It's so luxurious.
Well, that's not surprising. This is your 4th time on this boat.
Yeah, how do you have enough money to take all these round cruise trips? It must cost a fortune.
Whenever I'm off the boat, I'm a hard-working lady. I go back and forth to Vice City to work there too.
Oh my god, will you please turn that crappy song off?
Why? I love Rebecca Black.
It sounds irritating. Trust me, there's a reason why that chick is dead. By the way, at 9 p.m. sharp, I'm going to be expecting some wine. So please, deliver it to my room on time.
Why can't you just get it yourself?
Because I paid for this, and it's your job to serve me. So stop being lazy and bring me some wine at 9 p.m. Toodles.
At least she isn't a regular customer.
You can say that again.
Hey, cutie. What's a cute girl like you doing on a boat like this?
If you're trying to persuade me, you're failing miserably. and I'm on my way to a boarding school for the gifted.
Well, nice. My name is Adam. I'm on here to meet some fine ladies, like yourself. Chicks always dig me, especially when they see me riding my moped.
A motorbike? Interesting. I actually used to rely on one for convenient transportation until it got destroyed in an accident.
Really? What happened?
I was injured by a car striking me in the year 2023. How on earth do you find that amusing?
You worded that so artistically. Girls like you usually don't talk like that.
You're a pig.
What the hell?
I finally found you! Can I please have your autograph? What room are you staying in?
Why on earth would I tell you? Get out of my face!
Blimey! That's no way to talk to a dedicated fawn!
Who are you?
I'm the one and only J.J. Jarrett, an aspiring rock legend on her way to Vice City. Don't even bother with that grumpy old bloke. You can be my fawn instead.
No thanks. I only came here to meet Joe Winko. He's a survivor of the Woods Creek murders and he's in the Stab movies.
So what? My latest music video got 500 views on YouTube.
Sorry, lady, but I'm a Joe Winko fan, not a zero-hit wonder follower.
Well, fine. I'll remember this day once I'm in the spotlight. Bloody hell! This place is aching for a music video! Oh well.
Wow, this is nice.
This news in, a young couple was killed at the motel behind me last night. According to a material witness, the killer was wearing a Ghostface costume, and the motive was robbery for 2 cruise ship tickets.
Thank you.
Hey, gorgeous. What's going on?
Excuse me, can you afford a Mercedes-Benz?
What?
Clyde.
Hey, dude. It's cool.
I'm having a blast! Is this a party or is this a party? I can't hear you people!
Will you please keep it down? That is so irritating!
Brent! Cut it out! You're embarrassing me! Again!
Lighten up, Bridget. Let the kid have some fun.
I'm sorry, Mackenzie, but I have to agree with Bridget. He is being very obnoxious.
Obnoxious is an understatement to describe the way he's been acting.
Hey, Joe, where have you been?
Can I talk to you? Can we go inside the lobby?
Sure. What's going on, Joe?
I was watching the news in my room. Two people were killed at a motel last night. There was a witness who said that the killer was dressed in a Ghostface costume, and they stole tickets from their bodies.
But what does that have to do with us?
Think about it, Briary. We're on a cruise ship, and the killer was wearing a Ghostface costume, and the tickets were stolen from the victim's bodies. We're not safe on this boat.
Actually, you are.
Who are you guys?
I'm Sherry Chambers, and this is Albert Wesker.
We boarded this ship to watch out for any suspicious activity.
Suspicious activity? Then why are you following us? Shouldn't you be watching everyone else aboard this ship?
Don't worry, sir. So far, there's nothing suspicious about anyone here.
That's how it always is before we find out who the killer is.
Joe, please, calm down.
Hey guys, I heard yelling. What's all the fuss about?
Nothing, Mackenzie. Don't worry about it. We'll be right back out. Joe, you seriously need to calm down. If you act up like this, everyone on this ship is gonna think you're crazy. No offense or anything.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
I am. Now let's go on the docks. Maybe you need some fresh air. Felicity, what's wrong?
This cruise is just so lonely.
I don't know how I can help, Felicity.
Hey, beautiful. You look down. What's going on?
I just feel so alone. My lover just left me a few days ago, and he's all I can think about.
Well, that's not good. Maybe you need a stud like me to take your mind off of him. I'm Adam, and it's very nice to meet you. You're the most beautiful lady aboard this ship. How about we go back to my room and see how we hit it off?
Sure, this sounds romantic.
That can't end well.
You can say that again. The poor girl is just booking another ticket to the Heartbreak Hotel.
You're so stupid, Heather. I hate being here with you. I don't like being here with you either. So far, this vacation sucks. Fine, I'm going back to my room. I hope I never see you again for the rest of the night. And I hope I never see you again for the rest of my life. Hello?
Hello, Heather. It doesn't seem like you and your sister get along so well.
Tell me about it. Mom and Dad always thought she was smarter and cuter and prettier, but none of it's true. By the way, who is this?
Don't worry. You'll find out soon enough.
Darn it. It's probably Pamela playing another stupid prank on me. What the hell are you doing here? Get out of my damn room! What the hell are you talking about? This is my room! Well, it'll be a cold day in hell before I sleep in a room with you again!
Oh wow! Joe Winko's room! This is amazing! Joe Winko merchandise! This will sell for millions on eBay! What else can I find in here?
Am I the only one that notices how quiet it is here?
Woohoo! Party time!
You just had to say something, Brittany.
How may we help you, sir?
I'm finally 21! I would like everything on the liquor menu!
Sir, I know you're excited, but I really don't think that's...
No, Valerie. Let him have it. It'll quiet him down for a bit.
I'll be right back.
Hey, you're Joe Winko.
Yeah, that's me.
My name is Brittany. Is there anything I can do for you?
Could you get me something to drink?
Sure. What would you like?
Anything that doesn't have alcohol. As much as I need to, I really don't want to get drunk tonight.
Okay, I'll be right back.
Oh my god! What are you doing in my room?
I thought this was my room.
Do you seriously think that you would be able to afford a room this fancy? Now, please leave. My bodyguard will be happy to show you the way out.
Don't let me catch you around here again, kid. Hey, who is that?
Come in!
Hey, Bridget, have you seen your son anywhere?
No. Why are you asking?
Well, I can't find him anywhere. He was with us on the docks, and then he disappeared.
Well, I don't know where he is. Maybe he got drunk and fell off the boat. Hopefully.
Excuse me, ma'am, does this belong to you?
Hey, sexy ladies. What's up?
Oh, my lord.
Yeah. We were looking for him.
Looks like he got a little too carried away with turning 21.
Well, if you need our help with anything, just call us. Good luck.
Yeah, we'll need it.
I've been waiting for this night to come.
Of course. Can we get on with it already?
Yes, but before we do, I just want to say that I love you, and we are going to have a long, beautiful life together.
Now hold up. Excuse me?
You told me that I was your favorite lady, and that you loved me.
Well, tonight you are. But I'm not sure about my whole life, Missy. Damn! What the hell does a man have to go through to get laid? Drama queen.
Did you hear that?
It sounded like someone screaming.
I think someone might need our help.
But we don't know where it was coming from.
Well, let's split up then.
Okay.
Hey, pretty lady.
Hello, sir. May I help you with anything?
Certainly. How about you come over here and climb in bed with me?
Sorry, sir, but even if I was authorized to do that, I'd still say no. Stop that push and shove it, yeah. Don't wanna know about that love.
Hello?
Hello, Adam. You're quite the heartbreaker, aren't you?
Who's this?
Why don't you guess?
Is this some kind of joke?
Why? Do you find it funny?
Let me guess. This is the part when the killer jumps out and murders me.
Edgar? Valerie? Is that you?
I cannot believe this.
Don't sweat the small stuff, Bridget. I'm going to take a shower.
What about him?
I'm sure he'll sober up by the time we reach Vice City.
Hello?
Hello, Bridget. How's your vacation going?
It'd be a lot better if my son wasn't so out of control. Who the hell is this anyway?
I'm the last person you're ever going to see alive.
Whatever.
What's going on out here?
Ha 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 I need to change out of these clothes. Has someone else been in here? It's too dark to see anything.
I am so proud of you, Gabe. So far, you're doing a tremendous job. You're going to be a great sailor.
Well, Dad, I'm sorry, but this isn't me.
What do you mean?
This whole time I spent with you on this ship was awful.
But I thought you liked sailing. You said you wanted to be just like me when you grew up.
I'm sorry, Dad, but I'm already grown up, and I changed my mind. You're on your own now.
Gabe? Gabe, is that you?
Joe, what happened?
I saw him! He's here! There's a killer on the ship!
Joe, it's probably just your imagination.
Yes, whatever you saw down there was probably just an illusion.
Well, there's a huge illusion in my room downstairs! Someone was killed inside!
Okay, let's take a look. Somebody broke your mirror. Looks like we're dealing with a breaking and entering case here.
What? But I was attacked! Someone else was here! And the body was here too!
Calm down, Joe. We can't help you if you're a nervous wreck.
I'm sorry to say this, Joe, but she's right. How about you come back to my room? We can talk this over.
Sherry and I will come too, if you don't mind.
JJ, are you down here?
You, there was a killer on this boat! Do you believe me now?
Relax, Joe. It's just a power outage. You two wait here. Sherry and I are gonna go talk to the captain. We'll be back soon. Oh my God.
I'm scared, Briary. They didn't believe me, but there really is a killer on this boat.
Don't worry, Joe. They'll handle it. Everything will be fine. Hello?
Did you both really think you could get away from me?
Listen, if this is a joke, you better leave us alone. Officer Wesker and Sherry will arrest you if you keep bothering us.
Too bad. They're both dead.
Joe, you're right. There is a killer on this boat.
What about Wesker and Sherry?
They're both dead. We have to get the hell out of here.
Joe, Briary, we have to escape. They're going to kill us.
They?
Hurry up!
my god. This is a disaster. Not only did I lose my bodyguard, but I lost all my outfits on that boat. When I get home, I am definitely going to sue.
What are we going to do now? We're stranded.
We have to find an island where someone can help us.
Joe, get in touch with reality. We're out in the middle of nowhere. Where are we supposed to find an island?
Right there in front of us.
Oh my god! It's Vice City! We made it!
Yeah, whatever. So, can we just get there already? This boat is giving me split ends.
Okay, so we're here. Now what?
We need to split up and look for help. Briary, you head east. I'll head west. And Ivy, you can go...
No way! I'm staying right here.
Why?
Because! I'm tired, I don't feel like walking, and look at this bikini I'm wearing. It's so 1970s.
Okay, Ivy. You can wait here. Take my cell phone. Just in case you need a call for help.
Hello?
I'm surprised you're still alive, Ivy. Usually girls like you don't make it to the finale.
Finale? What are you talking about? What do you want?
I want you. It's showtime.
No!
Hello?
Hello, Briary. Are you ready to find out who we are?
What do you want?
Meet us on top of the hill straight ahead. We'll show you.
Thank you.
Joe, you're alive.
Of course I am. Let's get out of here.
Joe, I'm scared. The boogeyman is coming after me tonight.
Briary, there's no such thing.
But Luke told me he was real, and he's going to kill me.
Forget him. He was just trying to scare you. No boogeyman is going to get you while I'm here.
But what if the boogeyman gets you?
That's impossible, Briary. I'm here with you tonight, and I'm not about to let anything happen to you.
Promise.
Promise.
I was going to marry her here, but until she got caught up in your mess, I had to bury her here instead.
Why? Why did you kill him?
Because you killed the love of my life!
My own daughter! And my sister!
I loved Rebecca! She was everything to me! And we had a long life ahead of us, but you... stole it! I stalked you for months. It wasn't until recently that I found out that you were boarding a cruise line in the Atlantic.
That's when we all decided that you had to pay. We had to kill that poor trashy couple back at the hotel! To give me a free ticket!
And we had to kill the rest of those annoying people on the ship to eliminate them as witnesses.
Along with your tough friend, Joe Winko?
Looks like you have no one to save you now, Briary.
Drop your weapons now!
You're all under arrest for murder.
Good afternoon, Chief.
Good afternoon, Officer Riley, Officer Prescott, and Officer Weathers. What happened to the criminals?
We locked them up in a maximum security. They aren't going anywhere.
We were able to locate the ship, but there were no survivors on board. All of them were stabbed to death.
Three of them managed to escape ship. Joe Winko, Briary Rose, and a young woman who we didn't identify.
We never recovered the bodies, but we saw all of them die. One of them was stabbed in the heart, and the other one was shot multiple times. There is no way they wouldn't have survived.
I'm afraid we got there too late.
You guys did all you could.
This is Terry Holland reporting live from Vice City, where the police confirmed that there were no survivors aboard the SS Mariana.
Among those deceased is 48-year-old Joe Winko and 32-year-old Briary Rose Harold.
Joe Winko and Briary Rose Harold are now dead. Despite this tragic and depressing news, closure has finally arrived for them, and an awakening from their lifelong nightmare has finally come.
Wow, I can't believe it. They really think we're dead.
Please! It takes way more than a couple stab wounds to kill me.
Where are we going anyway?
Far away! Where no one will know who we are, and where no one will ever mess with us again.
Whatever. Just make sure it's someplace warm, tropical, and with a jacuzzi.
Thank you.